My name is Eric C. Larson. I'm a Roxborough resident and a consumer, provider, and survivor of the mental health system. I currently work as a peer leader, certified peer specialist coordinator at the nonprofit company Resources for Human Development. I come with a question and a story. The question, what does it mean to be a person in recovery? It means to me to get back on your feet after a traumatic event or devastating challenge that has exhausted your resources mentally, physically, emotionally, and financially. For the last 20 years, I have struggled to become part of the taxpaying community since my onset of schizophrenia in 1993. I cannot describe the resiliency and perseverance it has taken to learn the self-care skills of living with this illness, while at the same time working to gain the proper skills and work experience necessary to be successful in this competitive society. I assure you that despite my efforts, I could not have done this without the help of caring individuals and professionals that were willing to walk and nurture me shoulder to shoulder. These caring individuals often thought outside of the box to be inclusive and to create multiple levels of experiential training to guide me through the transition of consumer to professional provider of human services. I distinctly remember the transitional points when I went from group member to group facilitator, from certified peer specialist student to certified peer specialist trainer, and now to coordinator of services. I remember being asked to sit on the advisory boards of organizations that helped support me. As a coordinator of peer support services and peer leader, it is my duty to relay the message that people can and do recover. Research has shown that two things help to facilitate recovery. These are relationships and environments. Healing relationships within the community and the environments to help facilitate these relationships take dedicated professionals and progressive programming to create these environments that serve as a catalyst for growth. When people do not have the appropriate resources to recover, we are faced with a disenfranchised population that marginalizes these individuals even more, namely homelessness, hospitalization, or even prison, costing us both financial and human collateral. During my 20-year journey recovering from schizophrenia, I've used the necessary supports such as SSDI and Medicaid benefits. I have also utilized groundbreaking programs such as the CompEAR program and the workshops of the Mental Health Association of Southeastern Pennsylvania to learn wellness recovery action planning and to become a certified peer specialist. These programs took an anxious young man and used my experience to manifest a wounded healer and champion for the downtrodden. These are the very programs that helped nurture my career skills, and I am proud to say that I've been working and off benefits for 10 years now. Without these services reconnecting me to the community, I fear I would most likely have been warehoused in a state hospital, a prison, or even worse, dead. Please do not underestimate the damage these block grant 20% budget cuts will have on these extremely necessary services. This 20% cut will decimate recovery transformation and community inclusion, forcing a return to the by far less efficacious medical model. Research studies have shown that environments that promote recovery through progressive programs are more cost-effective and help people heal. An interesting study that can be Googled is the three-decade study of Vermont and Maine behavioral health systems, talking about the differences between a progressive system and a system that focuses on stabilization, medication, and institutionalization. Cuts to the essential services of general assistance will devastate this vital lifeline. Being both a recovering person and a provider of services requires funds for a full array of services to sustain the well-being of myself and my peers. Peer leadership has the potential to transform and mobilize a historically forgotten population. We are advocates, survivors, creative, and determined. We have the potential to overcome, and with the deep empathy that only comes from the lived experience, we have the potential to lift ourselves and others up. We will advocate and organize better services and create value-based organizations and businesses with great potential to give back. I implore our society to not replicate the neglect of the past of our most vulnerable citizens and seek sustainable long-term solutions for fiscal responsibility. Being in this environment here in the conservatory of the cemetery is kind of unique because I didn't expect to be here, but I included on my testimony a website for the Memorial for Recovered Dignity that's been created just for us to think about the population of people that were pretty much, you know, not even memorialized in their lives, that were simply had little grave markers with numbers on them from the state hospitals. And it's a really powerful image that I come with. And so that website's included on my testimony. Thank you for just your partnership and willingness to listen.